Good day, student. Welcome to today's lecture. ECO 202, Introduction to Macroeconomics, Study Session 5, Aggregate Demand and Supply. Learning outcomes for Study Session 5. When you have studied this session, you should be able to explain national income determination of aggregate demand, describe the concept of withdrawal and injection approach to national income. National income determination of aggregate demand. Demand for goods and services provided in an economy is regarded as the aggregate demand. That is, the national expenditure on goods and services produced in a country. This national expenditure consists of private consumption expenditure, government consumption expenditure, and investment expenditure or capital goods. Hence, aggregate demand is the relationship between the total quantity of goods and services demanded and the price level, all other determinants of spending unchanged. It can be written and mathematically tells Y is equal to C plus I plus G, that is aggregate demand. When the economy is in equilibrium, the aggregate demand must be equal to the aggregate supply of goods and services. When this happens, aggregate supply of final goods and services will equally be Y, which is national income. Factor affecting aggregate demand. Aggregate demand can increase or decrease depending on several things, which are exchange rate, distribution of income, expectation, monetary and fiscal policy. Exchange rates. When a country exchange rate increases, then net exports will decrease and aggregate expenditure will go down at all prices. This means that aggregate demand will decrease. Another factor is the distribution of income. This is directly related to wages and profits. When workers' real wages increase, then people will have more money on their hand because their overall income has increased. When this happens, they tend to consume more, causing the consumption expenditure to increase. Another one is expectations. Consumers tend to have certain expectations about the future of the economy, and we adjust their spending accordingly. And another one is monetary and fiscal policy. The government has some ability to impact aggregate demand. They can spend money or increase taxes in order to influence how consumers spend or save. An expansionary fiscal policy causes aggregate demand to increase, while a contractionary monetary policy causes demand to decrease. Withdrawal and injection approach in an economy. Withdrawal and injection are terms used in describing economic expenditures and related to circulation of money in an economy. Injection is one of the approaches to increase the finance in economy. The money is injected into the economy through injection elements such as consumption, investments, government expenditure, and exports. This will lead to increase in national income. Injection equation thus goes like this: I plus G plus X, where our I represents investments, our G represents government expenditure, and our X represents exports. Let's now go to our withdrawal. Withdrawal is just opposite to injection. When the money is taken out from the economy, it will be considered as withdrawal, like saving, taxes, and imports. This component will decrease national income. This is the equation for withdrawal, which we have S plus T plus M. Our S stands for savings, our T stands for taxes, and our M stand for imports. And our injection was always equal to our withdrawal. So therefore, the equation for injection equal to withdrawal will thus go like I plus G plus X, which stand for injection, equal to S plus T plus M, which stand for withdrawal. Thanks for listening. Hope you enjoyed the class. See you another time. Bye for now.